Okay, I'm going to give a quick tutorial on how to make over a picture, retouching, etc. This is what we're going to start with, and in the end, we will end up with this. Alright, so I'm going to go ahead and erase those. First thing, blemishes. You should know how to do that if you know anything about Photoshop. Just go over here to the spot healing tool, select that. And then just go around and click on the face and take those off. So from there to there, I didn't spend a whole lot of time doing it. Okay, next we're going to figure out how to soften the skin. And I'll zoom in so you can see the difference in the before and after. This usually looks better on girls. And as you can see over here, I ended up masking back in the eyes, the hair, the things I wanted sharpened. But to do that, I went to Filter, Noise, Reduce Noise. And my computer's going to run slow. Okay, turn the strength all the way up, all the way down. Turn this one not all the way up, but 3/4 the way up, and this all the way down. And then I hit OK. I'm going to hit cancel now because I already have that. It gives a nice soft look on the skin. It's especially good on girls. So there you go. Dodge and burn layer. This is where you make everything just really pop. And it's pretty simple. Let me show you what it looks like without anything else. We're trying just the dodge and burn layer. You can see where I just real quickly went over everything. I didn't spend much time on this. But to get a dodge and burn layer, I'm going to go ahead and just turn this one off. Go up to layer, new layer, and I chose overlay, fill with 50% gray, and I hit OK. And then all you gotta do now, take your brush tool and you turn the opacity down to, I don't know, somewhere around there. And then white, I cancel that. White will make the whites brighter. And you can just go around and do that. Any areas that you want to brighten up, you make that brighter, make it really pop. I did a lot along here. And then if you turn on the black, you make these darker portions pop even more. You make the eyes darker, you make them lighter, whatever you prefer. This also works if you choose a color, say red. You can put makeup on girls, make them look all beautiful like that. I usually look it up online, just find some makeup I like and then I just emulate it. I'm going to delete that. This is my dodge and burn layer. And then next thing I did, I just removed a little bit of red because digital tends to put a little bit more red in than I like. I did a basic curves layer. I'll show you what I did. You should know how to do this. Pretty much what I did over here, I just brought this up a little bit. It's kind of a thing for taste, but usually this will give you good a black point. But that's okay. I'm gonna delete that. High pass filter just makes everything a little bit more sharp, which is kind of the opposite of what we did with the dodge and burn layer, but you just gotta mess with it. What I do for that, I just copy the original layer. I copied blemishes since that's the fixed one. Copied that, went to filter, other, high pass. And I'll just go ahead and do it. I put it around 3.5 and it'll show you everything. If you really want, you can choose a 50% gray and you can mask out the areas that you don't want sharpened, but I didn't do that. And then, oh, you also, once you have it, you'll have a layer like this. You choose overlay. And then let's see what I do with curves. Just a bit, another small adjustment. The red layer is something I really like. It's kind of like an auto dodging burning. If you go into channels, select the red layer, you'll get this. Go to select all, or you can use your shortcuts, and then copy, and then once you have it copied, choose this all back, go to layers, hit control V to paste it in, and then I do a hard light, which really makes it pop, and then I lowered it to 15%. You just gotta see where you like it for each image varies. This is what it looks like at 100%. It's a very, really blows it out, gives it really high key look. But I'm going to lower that back down to 15%. And I'm not sure where I did this curves layer. I think I did a final curves layer after I adjusted everything just to make it pop a little bit more. And that's what I do. That's just a crash course in what I do for facial retouching. There's a lot more you can learn. That's everything I know in just a couple minutes. So we went from that to that, and it only took me about an hour.